Friday Night Funkin' is a simple riddle game released back in 2020 for the Ludum Dare. Just kidding. I think you all know what the game is. So you wanna make a sprite for your little FNF mod, but you can't figure out how cause you're not advanced enough to pirate Adobe Animate or commission someone online? Well, today I'll be showing you how to draw and animate your own sprites, as well as how to put it in a mod as a little bonus at the end. Without further ado, let's get started. In this video, I'll be using the free painting program Krita, but it should work with other programs with similar functions. I'll also be using PsychEngine at the end to import the sprite in, as it's the most used engine for FNF, but again, it should work with pretty much any engine. So here we are in Krita. First thing we're gonna do is create a new canvas, so go to File, click New. Now just set how big you want your canvas to be and click Create. Okay, now that we have a canvas, we can start drawing our little dude. Our little Friday night fucker. Yeah. Note that you should draw each body part on a different layer so that they're not merged together. Your face layer should also be separate from your head layer so it's easier to redraw for later. For coloring, your color layers should be under each respective body part. After you've done all that, make sure to group each line art and color layer accordingly using Ctrl G. You don't really have to do this, but it's good for organization purposes. Now that we're done with drawing, we can move on to the animation. To view the animation tab, go to Windows, Workspace, and Animation. Now it looks like there's a lot happening, but we'll only be using the animation timeline and the disk preview. There's also an onion skin feature you can enable to help out with animating, but I won't be using that in this tutorial. So first of all, you wanna go to the first keyframe of your layers and add a frame. Do this for every single frame. Pretty annoying, but you have to do this for your first frame every time. Don't know if there's a simpler way to do this, but if you do, do mention it below. That'll help a lot. Now that that's done, we can start with the idol animation. Since this is a basic tutorial, I'm gonna only be using 6 frames for the idol. Pretty bare bones, but that's pretty much the same amount of frames Daddy Dearest has for his idol. First, I'm gonna make the head bob that you usually see on this kind of stuff, so go to the second keyframe, select the head, and rotate it a bit. You can use your arrow keys to move it by a pixel. And there you go, we got something going on here. Now I'll be repeating that for 2 more frames. Third keyframe, rotate, and move it slightly more than the last one. Now, the 4th frame is going to be a bit different. This will be the lowest point of our character head bob. So rotate it and move it significantly lower. This might look weird, but it's gonna look good, trust. Now for the last 2 frames, to make your life easier, just go to the second keyframe, select both of them, copy, and paste onto the 5th frame. Then go to the first keyframe, select, copy, and paste onto the last frame. And there you go, we got a finished, simple head bob. That looks a bit fast, so I'll change the frame rate to 12. That's better. Now I'm gonna do the arms, starting with the right arm. Instead of starting from the second frame, I'm starting from the third frame. This makes your idol less stiff and a lot smoother. Of course, you can just start from the second frame if you want. Now that that's done, I'll move over to the left hand and do the same thing. Right, it looks a bit funny, but whatever. Alright, now to make it look better, I'm gonna group all the body parts. Name it, whatever, can be your character name. Now I'm gonna go to the 4th frame and squash our little guy a bit. I'm also gonna select his side, hold Alt, and stretch him so it also copies to the other side. This time I forgot to copy the torso and the last frame. Give me a bit. Okay, now go to the 5th frame and do the same thing but with less squats and stretch. And the idle animation should be complete. It looks janky but I'm sure you can do better. It's pretty decent for a basic one. Moving on to the singing animation, I'll only show you how to do the left pose. Each pose will have 2 frames each. That's how I usually do it, but you can increase it if you want to. First, I'm gonna go to his face layer and change his mouth. And I'll do the same for the eyes. I'm gonna change his right arm by just going to the layer and erasing parts of it. Alright, now to animate. I'm gonna make him lean to the left, because of course it's the left pose. And for the torso and legs, I'm gonna select both of them and skew them to the left a bit for simplicity. Right, for the 2nd frame, I'm gonna exaggerate the lean. So we have that iconic, I don't know, whatever you call this. And there's one of the singing animations done. Gonna do this for the other 3 poses and I'll be right back. I'm back and done with all the animations. Here's a little preview. It's pretty basic, but that's the point. You can touch it up however you want. Now that the animation is done, you can export all the frames into a spreadsheet and put it into Second Gen. Go to File, Render Animation. Make sure Export as Image Sequence is ticked. Untick the one below because we're not making a video. Set the location to wherever you want the frames to be and export. Cool, all your frames to be exported. I just remembered that I forgot the icon, so we're gonna do that right now. Create a new canvas, set it to 300 by 150 pixels, because that's how Second Gen generates icon images. See if we're not animating, go to Window, Workspace, and select Default to get rid of the animated stuff. Now I'm gonna make a quick icon for my little guy. Make sure each icon is 150 by 150 pixels. And looks like it is, so just export it normally. Right, as you can see, there's all the frames I drew. Ignore this black background, you see all of them should be transparent. I have no idea why it's doing that. So to make the sprite sheet, I'm gonna use the sprite sheet and XML generator. This isn't how I make sprite sheets, but since this is a basic tutorial, this tool helps you a lot. Now that we have this window, click Add Frame Images and find your character frames. Now select all of your idle frames and set the animation name as idle. Repeat this for the singing animations. Go to View, Preview Animation, make sure animation loads correctly. It looks a bit fast, so change it to 12 FPS. Once you've made sure everything's alright, just generate the XML. As you can see, we have the spreadsheet and XML file here. Now to export it to Second Gen, make sure you open your mod folder. Go to Images, Characters, select your spreadsheet and XML and copy them over to the other tab. Now go to Assets, Share, Characters, and copy the .json file. Go back to your mod folder and click Characters, and paste the file. Rename it to your character and open the file. Right, time to do a bit of coding. So make sure your XML file is also open. Go to the name section under each animation prefix and change it according to the name in the XML file. Should be pretty straightforward. For the health bar color, I'm gonna view it in Krita, so go to settings, dockers, specific color selector, now color pick your character and find the RGB value. Then copy that over to the JSON. Change the health icon to your character name. Oh yeah, don't forget to change the image there to its real character name, that's kinda important. To port your icon, just find it in your files and copy it. Go to your mod folder, images, icons, and paste it. Rename the file to icon-dash and your character name. Alright, you're pretty much done. Now just open PsychEngine. Press 7 on the menu and go to Character Editor. Hey BF. On the top right, change the character to your little guy. Now I'm gonna move him to roughly where the daddy deer's outline is, as that's the basic placement for enemy sprite. Now repeat for the other poses. Once you're done, click Save Character, go to the character folder with the JSON file, and simply replace it. And you're good to go! You can test it out on a chart editor with a random song. As you can see, my little blob guy appears on the stage. Let's put some notes down. And there's the sync animation, it's working perfectly. Tutorial done, here's your 100 XP to level up to level 2, and thank you for watching. This one took a while to make thanks to the power of procrastination and laziness, but here we are. Hopefully you learned a thing or two from all that yapping. Again, this is simply a beginner tutorial for those who don't know what the fuck to do. There's probably an advanced tutorial out there if you search for one. But yeah, that's about it. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.